Our prosperity as a nation depends upon the personal financial prosperity of each of us as individuals. Our country can only be truly rich if we are rich. The retelling of the richest man in Babylon is a storybook for kids from 1 to 92. It's for everyone who wants to be rich.
8,000 years ago, there was a prosperous place called Babylon. Arkad was the richest man in Babylon. He was generous to his family, friends, and those in need. And yet, each year, his wealth grew bigger and bigger.
Then, I noticed one thing. Wealth increases a person's ability to be happy. A man who has enough can help others. Wealth is power.
He went on to say, young people always think that their new ideas are better than old wisdom. But I tell you, the sun that shines today is the same sun that will shine on your forefathers and will be the same sun that will shine upon your great-grandchildren. This is also true with old wisdom. It is the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow.
I found the road to wealth when I decided that a part of all I earned was mine to keep, and so will you. Pay yourself first. It should not be less than 1/10, no matter how little you earn. It can be as much as you can afford.
The second law of money. Get into a business that you understand and seek advice only from those who are competent because of their own experience.
Al-Ghamis said, the third law of money is make your gold work for you. Make an army of golden slaves before you buy luxury. With that, he went away.
His face became serious. Arkad, you have learned and practiced the three laws of money. You now know how to acquire it, how to keep it, and how to use it. Therefore, you are now ready for a bigger responsibility. I went to be poor and took charge of Al-Ghamis' properties. My ambition and my mastery of the three laws of money helped me increase the value of the properties extremely.
Friends, you seem to think that wealth is limited. But I tell you, the world is abundant. Wealth is created wherever men exert energy and do work. I advise you to take the wisdom of Al-Ghamis and save yourselves. A part of all I earn is mine to keep. I pay myself first. Say it to yourself until the words stand out like letters of fire across the sky.
Turning point in the men's lives came upon that day when they understood and followed the wisdom that had come from Al-Ghamis to Arkad, and from Arkad to his friends, and now to us as readers. Now, gentlemen, are you ready to follow the laws of money to become truly rich?
Yes!
Yes. And what are